Yeah. Coach, week three of the Mountain West season is upon us. You head to Fort Collins or Laramie this week. Obviously, Fort Collins, you know, you have number 7 team ranked Nash there, and Wyoming is also 4th in the conference. So some tough teams ahead. But you also come off some great performances last week against San Jose State. Talk about the teams, you know, showing at home versus Nevada and San Jose State.
We started playing better making the changes we've had to make. We started, I thought that offensively we got better really fast. Defensively, we're not getting the output that we're looking for, and we're playing better teams this weekend. So we've been working on ways to defend them. And if we can do that offensively, we're starting to compete. So hoping that, like we did against San Jose, improving so much off the Nevada match and learning, you know, we've got to be tougher and more competitive in points 20 to 25. If we can build on that, then who knows what we can do this weekend.
You had 3 sets that go past 25. You had a 30-pointer in there. I mean, has that happened to you before here at Fresno State with 3 straight?
No, not in 3 sets. But it was a good test for us. And they've taken a few teams kind of to their limit in sets, and they haven't always come out on the winning side. But I was happy that if we had played the way we did against Nevada in those last few points, we probably would have lost. So I like that we got tougher, we got more competitive, we weren't sending over free balls, we were attacking them at whatever point it was. So those improvements are important, and I hope to build off it this weekend.
Were there key individuals that you remember stepping up at those points as far as leading or making key plays to step up?
Well, I'm really enjoying working with some of our younger players right now, that like Lauren Torres. She just couldn't find the block on Thursday, and so we watched video, and she started analyzing, you know, how the sets develop and how the hitters come in, and she actually made some changes and started touching more balls on Saturday. So we love seeing, even though we're inexperienced, we're not getting as many wins as we want. As long as we're seeing that kind of progress, it's really fun to coach.
And it's obviously, these kids are getting a lot more experience in different positions too. Talk about how they're adjusting to new roles on the fly.
Yeah, you know, we've had depth issues this year. We've had injuries that have crippled us a little bit, and sometimes you just have years like that. But it's giving people experience in new positions. Macy Murdoch is a senior, played on the right side last weekend, and she did some good things for us. And Lauren Torres has never played middle in her life. Or right side in her life, and had to make that adjustment. So, and we put the two twins, Molly Pearson and Katie Pearson, in the middle to improve some other parts of our game. So, hey, it worked. It gave us more offense. We were better out of system, things we've struggled with. So our changes worked. Our kids adapted to it. But defensively, it takes time to learn new positions.
And also, you're 6'2", kind of fully 6'2-ish. They're talking about kind of how the setters did together.
Yeah, I think our setters right now are better in the 6'2". You know, they don't have all the pressure, and I think they set a better game on Friday or on Thursday and Saturday than they have, and so it enhanced our offense a little bit. It gives us size at least in front, where we were really lacking, not having a true right side this year to help us. So it gives us size. We've just got to learn how to read a little bit better and defend.
With those changes at the right side, that means now you have some middle blockers there too. Talk about the performance of the Pearson twins.
Well, the Pearsons haven't given us a lot of offense, but they're really good at setting out a system. So we were struggling. Anytime we had a bad pass, we were making huge errors, killing ourselves. We weren't even able to compete. They come in, we're actually using them out of system to set because they're good at it. And our offensive output has improved dramatically just from doing that. So they're there for very specific reasons, trying to get them a little bit better at blocking and a little bit more offensive. But they can put balls away. They can become a threat if we put them in the right situations.
So this week you had Colorado State and Wyoming, not in that order reverse, but talk about what you know about them.
Wyoming has been playing well. They often do well in preseason and then in conference. I think they're a beatable team, but they're definitely playing well right now. They have a lot of offense, really good middles, one good outside, and certainly a threat on the right. So, they're going to be tough, but I think their weakness, if you can serve them tough, they're not quite as strong. So we're we're going to go after them tough. And Colorado State, obviously, they don't have any holes in what they're doing. They're playing really well. They've been ranked as high as 7th in the country. So we're going to have an outstanding performance against them.
So also, last week was the Wiggle Waggle Walk, and also the Step Up for Down Syndrome, that the breast cancer awareness there was also on Thursday. How fun was it for you, this program, to be a part of those community-type events?
Well, this program has always been really active in the community and a lot of community service events, and so we generally kind of stick with the things we really, really like. There's so many opportunities to help people in the community. So we've kind of connected with all of those different forums, and we've enjoyed working with each and every one of them, and I love seeing the people at our games and coming out and having a reason to celebrate, so it's good.
It's also baseball playoff time. Who are you cheering for right now?
Nobody.
Nobody at all?
No. I like college baseball.
No, you're not so at all.
Yeah.
Okay. Well, anyway, we'll be back to volleyball this week, Thursday, 6 o'clock at Laramie at Pacific Time, 7 o'clock there, and then it's at noon on Saturday at Colorado State at Pacific Time, 1 o'clock there. So yep. Go Dawgs.
Go Dawgs.
All right.